गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज आवर सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर टेडोफाइट एंड इन दिस पार्ट वी आर लर्न अबाउट द आउटलाइन एंड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टेडोफाइट। लेट अस सी वन बाय वन द डिफरेंट क्लासिफिकेशंस। और इन दिस पार्ट वी आर लर्न अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन। लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द आउटलाइन ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन। This classification is proposed by the K.R. Sproul in 1975, and he is divided the division Pteridophyta into the six major classes. Okay, out of these six classes, Psilopsida and Prognymospermopsida do not have any living representative. Let us see which they are. In which first one is the Psilopsida, it is extinct. Second one is the Psilotopsida, Lycopsida, Spinopsida, Pteropsida, and Progymnospermopsida. Okay, in this way, these are the different six classes. Let us see the outline. Here, division Pteridophyta again divided into these six classes: Psilopsida, Psilotopsida, Lycopsida, Spinopsida, Pteropsida, and Progymnospermopsida. In this way, these are the outline of classification of the gymnosperm. Let us see in detail. In which first one is the Psilopsida, it is the extinct class. Let us see one by one the different characteristic of this class. First one, it is the most primitive division of Pteridophyta, and they are represented by few fossil genera and only a single living genera Psilotum. That means here only one living plant is present in this group, Psilopsida, that is the Psilotum. All other the plants or genera, they are the fossil, in the fossil form. Okay, let us see the one by one the different characters. First one is the sporophyte with simple plant body. Okay, pteridophytic plant body. In pteridophyte or in Psilopsida, pteridophytic plant body is the sporophytic, and it consists of the subterranean rhizome. It having the rhizome, not roots. Okay, with dichotomously branch aerial shoot is present here. Let us see, this is the primitive one. That means it is the evolution. When evolution of bryophyte takes place, bryophyte is also having the rhizome, and this first class of pteridophyte, they also having the rhizome with dichotomously branch aerial shoot. So it is clearly seen that they are the evolved form of the bryophytic plant, or bryophyte is the ancestor of the pteridophytic plant. Second, true roots are absent, but rhizoid are present here. No true roots are present here. Third one is the true leaves are also absent, but scaly leaves are present here. Vascular strand is protostylic. Vascular strand is present, but it is primitive. These are the protostylic. Cambium is absent. Two, secondary growth is absent. So secondary growth is also absent because cambium is not there. Next one is the sporangia are born singly at the tip or in a group in the axile of the scaly leaves. That means at the topmost part of the scaly leaves, at the tip of scaly leaves, the sporangia are developed here. That sporangia are homosporous. Okay, they are, that sporangia, they are present on the plant, a single plant. Gametophyte is poorly developed into the endophytic fungi. Okay, gametophyte is produced, but that gametophytic, it is developed with the fungi, and that is the endophytic fungi. Anthrozoids, they are the multiflagellate. Okay, when gametes are produced, male gamete, that male gamete produces the anthrozoid, and they are the multiflagellate. Okay, there are the example of Psilopsida, that is the Rhynia, and Asterozylon. These are the two examples of the Psilopsida group class. Next class is the Psilotopsida. It is the living form, that is Psilotum. Only one living plant, Psilotum, is present in this group. And let us see one by one the different character. First one is the true roots are absent. Here also the true roots are absent, but rhizoid are present. True leaves are also absent. Scaly leaves are present. Vascular strand is protostelic. Here also protostelic primitive vascular bundle is present. Cambium is absent here, so secondary growth is absent. Sporangia are born singly at the tip in the group in the axile of the scaly leaves. Okay, and sporangia are homosporous. Homosporous sporangia, they are developed. And the example is the xylotome. What is the difference in the first and second class? Here, these are the living fossil, living group or living plant. Okay, this is the second class. Third one is the Lycopsida. Here, in Lycopsida, the Selaginella. Okay, or Lycopodium, these are the, or Isoetes, they are the example of the, we know about the Selaginella, okay, or Lycopodium, these are the examples of the Lycopsida. Let us see one by one the different character. First one, it is also represented by the fossil and a few living genera. Okay, here in this class, the both genera are there, fossil and also living. Sporophytic plant body, it is differentiated into the root, stem and leaves. Let us see here. In previous class, rhizome is there, but evolution takes place. And let us see here in this class, the true roots and stem and leaves are there in the sporophytic plant body. Okay, let us see here. Leaves, they are simple, microphyllous and may be dimorphic in nature. Okay, they are simple, leaves are present here. Vascular cylinder is protostelic or siphonostelic advanced structure. There are also in some plant protostelic present, in some plant siphonostelic condition are also present in the Lycopsida group. It is the different character than that of the other two. Next one is the sporophyll arrange in the strobilus. Okay, that is the cone, and they are the dimorphic in condition. Sporophyte may be the homosporous and heterosporous. They may be produced in the same plant or they may be produced in the different plant. Homosporous and heterosporous. Gametophyte is thalloid structure, and autotrophic endosporic. They are the autotrophic. They produce their own food material. These are the some character of the Lycopsida group. Example, Lycopodium and Selaginella. Next one is the Spinopsida. Okay. There are the example like Equisetum. We know about the Equisetum and Calamostache. Okay. These are the two examples. Out of that Equisetum, we are well known. And let us see one by one the different character. Okay, before that, the member of this group, they are commonly called as the horsetail, because the structure of plant like the horsetail and represented by the fossil member, and only a single living genera or genus, that is the Equisetum, is there. Okay, all other the genera, they are the fossil, in the fossil form. Let us see the characteristic. First one is the sporophyte is with the jointed hollow stem and scaly leaves with hole at the nodes. At nodal part, the holes, that means at the nodal part, the number of leaves are arises there. They are known as the hole leaves. Okay. True roots develop on the underground rhizomic stem. Okay. True root are developed here. Let us see. In previous, no true root system. Only root, stem and leaves are there. Here in this class, the true roots are developed. Reproductive shoot bears cone at the tip. Okay. And the sporangia develop on the sporangiophore. Okay. Sporangia develop on the sporangiophore, and the living form is homosporous only. Okay. This is one of the important character of the Siphonopsida. The living form, it is the homosporous. Gametophyte, it is the autotrophic and exosporic. And examples are the Equisetum and Calamostaches. This is about the class Siphonopsida. Let us see next class, that is the Pteropsida. The member of this group, they are commonly known as fern. Okay, we know about the fern plant. Nephrolepis is known as the fern. Adiantum, Marsilia, these are the different examples of this Pteropsida group. Nephrolepis is commonly known as the fern, and this member of this group are commonly known as the fern. and they are represented by the fossil as well as living genera. Out of that, Neprolepis, fern, they are the living. Plant body, it is the sporophytic, perennial. That means they grow, the life cycle, it is more than 2 years. It is known as the perennial. Okay, annual means only life cycle complete in 1 year. Biennial, life cycle complete in 2 years. Perennial, more than 2 years. Life cycle complete more than 2 years. It is known as the perennial and differentiated into the root, stem and leaves. Here, two roots, stem and leaves are there. Stem is usually subterranean rhizome with the true roots. Okay, let us see here. Two roots with rhizome is present here. And on that true root, stem is produced. Leaves are usually pinnately compound. Let us see. This is the first case. Here the compound leaves are arise here. Before that, the simple or small leaves are present there. But here, pinnately compound leaves with succinate venation is arises in this group Pterodactyla. This is the one of the important character of this group. The plant are homosporous or heterosporous. Sporangia develop in sori, okay, a globular structure, that is the sori, and in that sori or protective structure, the sporangia are developed on lower surface of sporophyll, okay. On sporophyll, that means the spore producing leaves. On that leaves, sori are developed, and in sori, sporangia is developed. Gametophyte, they are usually heart shaped. Okay, a heart shaped gametophyte is developed here, and they are the autotrophic example, Neprolepis, Adiantum, and Marshallia. Okay, in this way, this is about the characteristic of Pteropsida group. Next one is the this is the last group of this classification here, Progymnospermopsida. Here in this group, the two examples are there, Proteocallon and Archaeopteryx. These are the two examples of this class. But here, vascular cambium is with unlimited growth potential is present. Vascular cambium is present with unlimited growth. Okay, if vascular cambium is present, then there is secondary growth is occur here. Okay, and as well as the xylem and potential is present, as well as the xylem and phloem is also present there. Okay, these are the, if xylem and vascular, that means the it is somewhat advanced vascular system is developed into this group. Second one is the ancestor of the earliest seed plant as well as the first true tree plant is this. This group shows first true tree plant is developed in this group. Okay. Strong monopodial growth is exhibited here, and some are heterosporous but other are homosporous. Okay. Both homosporous and heterosporous both are there. And the example is the Proteocallon and Archaeopteryx. These are the example of this group, and it is the primitive of the gymnospermic plant. And we know that the gymnospermic plant, they are the trees, and here the first true tree is developed in this group. Before that, only the small plants, herbaceous like plant are developed in this group, but in this class, the first true tree plant is developed here. Let us see. In this way, the evolution can be takes place. After that, the gymnospermic plant, and that gymnospermic plant, it is the truly tree plants. Okay. In this way, this is about the classification of Pteridophyte. I hope you are understand that. Thank you. Thank you very much.